shown to you. Our scientists who are of local origin have explained to you. This is the first question you have to answer them. Is what is your cause? See, today the central government is making this regulation for not determining something which is not to be determined. The other question by Mr. Michael is saying is about 1974 notification. Now, and now I don't want to argue within Congress, BJP, whatever. I just want to bring facts to you. Is okay, you have taken the cadastral plan given by the Survey Department of Goa. We have a 1996 notification, as you have said, it is there also, somebody asked, it is there with me also on the table. But I want to ask you is why even when Mr. Parikar was the last time, I remember I was sitting, I did not comment, all we were discussing, I didn't want. Unfortunately, I am beginning to comment because I am the minister. Now, the scale of 1:25,000 was for the entire India. Mr. Parikar paid you an extra fee, is it correct? So that you can do a scale of 1:4,000, which you have done now and got it back. The question here we have is only 5 points, what we have. One is the CRZ line, that is the seaside, which you have not taken into account the river mouths. You have not taken into account the base of the particular area. You have not taken into account of the sediments which existed. This is what I am asking you. Second, in the river side, you have taken what should not have been taken. You have taken our conventional fishing, what was being done, ancestors, 5 generations before, which you have automatically, we were inviting water of the sea or the river inside our land, growing fish, and we used to have buns. Now this, because there is salinity, has been taken as part of the CRZ land. I think you have to first work on that. There is no tidal influence. I think it has all been done. Dr. Simon D'Souza has clearly given it to you. See, since you are the body of NCSM, you are part of NCSM, you are a seven such bodies which have been given by the central notification, which we as the state have to employ you or recruit you or whatever way, and do the study for us. I think we have to see the local sentiments, local things, just by using the language, and when you are not using and, it should have been or, it is and. So and means tidal influence should be there in wherever you are shown. No? Yeah. This is what the meaning is. So when it has been proved by our authorities to you that there is no tidal influence, you are still stuck to that point. What is the reason, may I ask you?
Because we have used the salinity measurement which was given by the state, and wherever the people think they have supplied the IPPT data, they have and the mangrove. There are two basic rules which they have in the National Coastal Zone Authority. There are two basic rules because we have taken for the entire country. Whenever there is a mangrove, that will be the end point of the part of the coastal regulation. So that mangrove can come after, say, 2011 also, but we have marked wherever the mangroves are there. That is so happened in Maharashtra, everywhere, there's huge sensitivity.
No,
that is one thing.
No, sir.
The second thing
is the you are confusing yourself. I asked a very simple question about marking your HPL line. I have not come to mangrove state. Mangroves will come subsequently.
Yeah.
Let us talk about one subject about the HTL line, high tension line.
High tide line.
What is that? How do you mark that? End of mangrove.
By definition, it is end of the mangrove.
End of the mangrove is one
stage.
What Vinay is asking is the same question I'm repeating again.
Yeah.
Have you referred to the revenue records to look at the land use? Is my basic question.
See, there are 7,500 maps, PT sheets was given to us.
Have you utilized the records for land use? Have you taken those? PT sheets don't give you land use.
No, we have used their land use, and then we have also used the aerial photographs to update it. And it was one presented many times here to the we have presented to the state.
The public at large is feeling your plans are totally inaccurate. For that, ground truthing also was required. But I feel in the last 1 year, or when we spoke to you last, and you were supposed to come with your presentation today, we have not seen any improvement from your side. And the Minister of Environment should intervene in this matter and ensure that corrections are done. We are not against the thought, but the thoughts are going wrong.
No, I agree. I'm not saying that we are here only to help the state government to go through the rules, because we will be answerable to the NGT as well as to the ministry. So what we are trying here, I'm saying, the correctness.
We are answerable to the people.
Government is suffering. No. You can just please talk about that. sovereignty is government is sovereign. Yeah. If you are talking about complying with the judicial norms, I think Nilesh has to intervene. Nilesh, he is talking about complying entity requirements. Government is supreme sovereign.
No. See, what he meant to say is 31st, obviously, the issue today, there are two issues. One is when in 86, when the central government decided to make the environmental notification, it was passed in parliament and it came subsequently to every state assembly. And state assembly accepted that regulation. Fair back at that. And subsequently in 1991, it has come into force. Now, the first plan was that to be done in 1996. Now, in Goa, unfortunately, that whoever that government was then has not done this plan in 1996. But they did a plan, I will explain to you. It is here with me. The original copy of the plan is right with me. The Goa State Committee of Coastal Environment, which was known as that time it is a GCDNA, whatever is known as, that time it was known as Goa State Committee of Coastal Environment, which this is a plan in my hand, it was prepared in June 1996. Now, this plan then, by that government then, was prepared on a scale of 1:10,000. And it was not like how we have a plan now, it is not a complete plan with details. Now, this is a plan for April. Subsequently, we have to do in 2011. In 2011, now again a notification has come on for January, somewhere in the month of January 17, that we have to do 2019 plan. We have not done 2011 plan. When the government had to do it 2011 also, it is not done. Now it is being done in 2011. Now what is happening? This is creating a lot of problems. It's like CRZ notification. This particular plan is only to demarcate the HTL line, the mangroves and all those things. This has got nothing to do with the idea behind this. This should determine the HTL line and again we'll have to go and make a 2019 plan. Now, even if somebody wants to build a house somewhere and STCP asks or your department asks to demarcate before conversion, demarcate the HTL line next to the river, next to the sea, where do we have to go? We have to go to NCCM and there where people are troubled and we have to get a certificate from them and that becomes validity. So what I am trying to say is we have apprehension about the plan. I also have particular apprehension of the plan. I have explained to them, see, scientifically you have to prove just because mangroves have grown, that is what the statement is Dr. Ramesh's beginning. Mangroves have grown means there is salinity. Now how mangroves have grown is because, I am telling you again, we have invited water inside for breeding of fish or whatever activity. You cannot assume that because mangroves have grown, it will create
a buffer zone.
So then create a buffer zone after that. So this is very wrong, which has to be corrected in our plan.
Sir, I fully agree. This has to be taken up to the National Coastal Zone Management Authority and has to be revised. That is what I am telling the
government. No, but sir, due respect to you, yeah. I have also said, I read it out to you.
Yeah.
And I said, I am reading it out to you. During the driest period of the year and distance up to which the tidal effects are, this is both combination. You are using your scientific methodology or your thinking that just because there are mangroves, it has got tidal effect. This is what I am trying to say. High tide, that is what I am trying to explain to you again. You are not trying to understand. You may be scientists, but we are also scientists in our field. What I am trying to tell you is, if you read the definition, and you are saying only mangroves because that's what Mr. Raja said. When mangroves have come there, means there is fine activity. Is it what you are saying again? That is what I am trying to tell you. Tidal influence is there. They prove to us that this particular area, what you have got, tidal influence is there. What is the tide? What is the meaning of tide?
Not scientifically.
One second. What is the meaning of tide?
The tidal flux, which goes every semi-diurnal, means it goes 2 times a day, which the maximum water level which goes to certain levels, and we have to delineate up to. When it can go in years also, we thought of 35 ppt, the minimum is 5 ppt. That is what we have given and drawn a line on that one.
I agree, sir. Now, when your people have gone on the ground, did they notice that there are bunds? Suppose I stop that water coming inside, what happens?
Same question I'm asking them. When
you put a bund, water is not coming inside. No? Is water going to come inside?
No.
So then what do you do?
All around the river.
Please. When the always put there. Because the system is not made by it is all generations together. Yeah. I told you 5 generations before.
Yeah.
So now you put that burn. Then what happens? Do you take it as a cattle and
this is what discussed in the ministry. What they said, if there is a mangrove beyond that one also, you take it.
Sir, we respect you. Shirodkar is the NIO scientist who is based on this, who knows what are the systems in this Goa. My request to you is you please implement these things first. And you, I am asking because I am reading it again in the first page. First page, you are always saying about your thing, is that in 5 ppb, mangrove means it should be SPL line, which is wrong.
If you could give us a take it to the committee.
This has been given to you by us, CRZ has written to you, our member secretary has been telling you, and again after 1 year, you are coming back and telling the same thing.
Summarize kar.
So I think, sir, first of all, we required a plan of 2011 in the interest of Goa and Goa. Because that is what will help us and help our population where demarcation and understanding happens. That is one. We also want 2019 plan also to come into effect.
I just want to mention 2019 the
Kazan
land has been
removed. Yeah, I know that. That is what, but we cannot go ahead. Because 2011 is not there. We can't supersede 2011 and go to 2019. That's what I am telling you to tell my colleagues. So we have to finish 2011. The only issue, sir, is in the sea line, that is a, it was a sea, you have to take proper, so if you have taken whosoever reference plan, I want hard copies. Before you go to public on 7th. If you are going, I want hard copies. Give us me hard copy, I had asked you to take, I asked a scientist here. I said, give me hard copies of what you have taken. They are saying, they have gone in the land survey, in the survey in India of India, they have viewed, they have taken view and put on that. I don't know. I am an engineer myself. How did it? I don't know. There may be science in a different way. No, sir. What I am saying, whatever you have used, have been part of a presentation, which is not there. First put that in the presentation, and what are the reference plan? What you have used, and to determine this. And secondly, as you have to see the base, the river mouth, it is standing again. This is for the sea side. The second side is in the river line, where it is very clear, where I am telling you, if tomorrow if the people of God decide that they close the sewage grid, there will be no mangroves. So it is our tradition that the mangroves have come and this has been pointed out by this gentleman to you. It is written and given to you in a meeting, but you have not taken up on top. So you have to do that first. That whatever mangroves have come inside the Koi, inside the Khazan, is not part of the high tide land. This is to be taken first. This is what I am trying to tell you. This is very important. Which is very, very important. I think when you take this, when you take this into this, your entire issue of demarcating of state land will come to one. Secondly, I will also forget me, I am a politician. Let us take another scientist other than your NCSL, who is also working for a similar organization like you, who is also employed. Mr. Shirodkar, I would like him to speak in and explain my colleague. Shirodkar,
you are referring to the cadastral plan. You are not referring to land use. And the cadastral plan of 74 itself differs with the 2010 survey plan. Now, which is the plan? Is your base referral plan? Is some clarity you guys need to give us? You are confusing us.
No, see, I'll explain it. I'll explain it. Don't worry. See, their mandate is very defined. They have no cadastral plan. They have to do based on the 1996 plan, which I'm sure I'll show you.
He told us 1970.
No, he has taken because, see, it is a mistake of the then government who was there, who did not take the cadastral plan into account. Listen to me. So if they had prepared in 1996 based on the cadastral plan, this issue would not have come, what you are trying to say.
Yeah.
So now we have to finish it, sir. We have to finish everything. So we have to find solutions. Now what you are saying, land use.
I would only suggest, as you look at land use, let them do an overall intensive exercise of ground truthing, taking MLAs, panchayat bodies in confidence, and finishing it.
That's a different thing. But what I am trying to say, Ronda. Now, Ronbab, see what has happened. If you remember, I am speaking English, not well, they should also know. There was a High Court case in 2006, 7, 8. The entire survey department for 3 years have done ground putting of almost 8,000 houses by comparing the 1973, 70, 70, 74 cadastral plan with the actual which is there and recorded in DSLR. Number one, which is already there in Kanpur, which is presented to the High Court, which is, I think there are the real people are here, they will explain to you. So that there is done for the as part of the seaside. But the riverside is not been done. But riverside, what you are saying, demarcation of STL and problem is it is determined to be 50 meters, not now, it is from before. But the line what they have shown is they have taken the POA and from there they have shown 100 meters or 50 meters. So what we are trying to tell is the POA is not this is to be collected by them first. That is one. So automatically it will go back to what it was before. What it was before as per this. Now, if we don't finish 2011 plan, again the people of Goa are going to suffer like what is happening right now in CRZ. NGT people are going, some activists are going and they are determining on the line and they are breaking the houses. As rightly pointed out by Churchill, one particular hotel in his constituency which was built in 1965 has been wholly demolished. So, but if we are going to find solution, I think we as legislators we have to find some conclusion and tell him that this is the way to go forward. And if we delay it further, you will see ground putting at this particular time, what we are all asking, it will take another 3-4 years. There is no problem. Government can pay and continue. Yeah. But 2011 plan will not notify. The benefit of 2019, what is there, is not going to come to the state of Goa.
But the mistakes made in 2011 by them,
that's what I say, no?
In terms of even getting micros and buffer zones, will hamper 2019
that
in
total. That is what? Before going to public. So then I am telling them, no, correct purpose is simple, no. What has happened? I have just taken over. What I have been told by my team and the senior decision who I took inputs, it was pointed out to them. They have gone on one contention. Mangroves means water has come, which is very wrong, sir. Mangroves means water has not come. Mangroves means the people of Goa invite water inside. And they have the mangroves, they want the mangroves for cultivating fish. This is what concept we have to put in their head. And remove that line from there, then I think 90% of the problem will be solved. So this you have to sit and do. Now, what you are saying, that you have to go to NCCM or National Authority, is when you have to go to National Authority, when first your study has to be proved that this is influenced by the high tide. Other states don't have that. All other states don't have that same issue. Yeah, but if they are done within their headache, we have government in their headache, I am responsible for the people of Goa. If they are done, you have few and they see. If it is for my state, it should be done this way. We have to first understand what is HTL line. That is the biggest problem for people here. All the MLAs talking about that line. Number one. Tell me, but before that, before you tell, I will like Mr. Shirodkar to speak.
Over.
Must to say, everything has been said by the environment minister. But what I would like to point out is, our stand always has been that beyond sluice gate, there is no tidal effect. Why? Because the sluice gate is not made to give an entry of the riverine or the sea water into the agricultural land. They were made long time back during, as the minister has already explained to you all, that after the agricultural crops, they were done. So people used to grow some fish inside by taking, whenever required, by taking the saline water. And that used to be closed. There used to be no tidal influence. Based on this point, we have always taken our stand that beyond sluice gate, there cannot be any tidal influence. And that is why no CRZ becomes applicable. So this is what has to be reviewed again, and has to be done. Then another question comes. Now why these mangroves have grown, and why this saline water is there? Because of the non-maintenance of many places. Not maintained at all. So once they are maintained, suppose a private person is having his private property, he is having a sluice gate there. Tomorrow he asks for a permission. When you are putting a line beyond the sluice gate to the water body, the HTL, then we cannot issue permission to them. But we are entitled for maintenance of the sluice gate. So this point also has to be taken care of. And this is to be reviewed.
This is what I was also saying, you know, scientists of the NRO is telling the same thing. So you can reply to his question.
Doctor, I would only suggest in one line. From the land use, your whole thing is sorted.
See, what you have done to all our paddy fields is only mangroves. You have not shown our sluice gate over here and the bandh. The bandh is here. You have not shown the bandh. Bandh of ours is 5 meters. They have given us permission to build this. This is what they have given us. But you have shown the entire paddy fields as mangroves. Then you have gone in our land also, up to here, and shown this as buffer. So all these houses which are there, some are doing commercial activities beyond 500 meters are coming in your buffer. So this is what we want you to rectify all over Goa. Not only in my constituency. All over Goa.
This is the issue what I have been telling you. I think you have been coming late. So I think we have to seriously sit. You tell us the solution on how to go about this. As this government is very severe in finding solutions to the people of Goa. And whatever in the past, because of 96 and 2011, is what we are suffering today, which has been accepted by everybody. So let us find solutions to this, and you tell us now. Now we will listen to you only, we will not speak.
No, I agree with the sentiments and with the sluice gate issue. And when it was presented to the Technical Advisory Committee, I think the director also was present there, and they have not accepted this argument. It is not like we want to do this one. This is the rules which is followed. What I humbly request you to raise this issue, maybe from the government side, to the ministry. The ministry, National Coastal Zone Management Authority, is the final authority who can decide whether the sluice gate can be closed.
You are preparing the plan. When we are telling you what is wrong in our plan, you have to correct the plan. Now what you are saying is the interception of that, I have been reading in the first page, and when there is no end, there is no tidal influence, then where is the question of you putting that in the CRZ land? So the question of us going there is not that you go and correct it. Why we should go?
Why
we are not going?
Why we will go?
We will not go. It is your head. Because your scientists are proving something what is wrong with what our people are saying. There is no power. It's not a question of power. This is not a question of power. This is the question of interpreting the law, the act on the first page. I'm again reading it to you. In the first page, it is very clearly said, based on salinity and concentration of 5 ppt measured during the driest period of the year and distance up to which tidal effects are present. Not the way you are saying. That because there are mangroves, that is why it is tidal effect. This is your wrong conception. You tell your body what I want to do with my body. So why should I go to the center and ask them? Your interpretation is wrong. You should interpret first and tell me how it is. Then if you have to require, then we'll go. Then your interpretation, you write and give me that this is your interpretation.
And postpone the meeting.
Otherwise, postpone the meeting. So, first, all our suggestions should be taken by your correct the plan. Then let us go for personal hearing, public hearing.
Don't go for public hearing.
Public hearing should be only after all our consultation is over and when it comes on the plan.
And the issues are addressed.
See, we are not conducting public hearing. Only government.
Public hearing date has to be postponed because you will be there for the public hearing.
Government is not ready for this.
Cancel now. Mr. Ramesh, see, I want to understand it again. GCRNA is conducting a public hearing on the plan drawn by you. Is it correct? So when the plan drawn by you is only wrong, the question of public hearing cannot arise. Now, let me finish. But in our interest of the state, we have to finish 2011 and 2019. Now your plan is when you are going to give the correct plan to the school and the or are you not going to correct what we have asked for? So tell me now, I am asking you one simple question. The issue raised here are only 4 points. I'm telling you again, is whatever scientists you have done, is you have based on, I don't know what, you were claiming, I would like to see the document myself, I ask them, they have not carried it, if I have to come somewhere, I will come, if we have to come, we will come, that is one part of it. Second part of it, what we are saying is, there are four things, after repeating again, it's not correct to repeat, one is the sand dunes, one is the river mouth, one is the bay, as far as the seaside is concerned. The remaining riverside, I am repeating again to you that what we say, I am reading, what I read, I am asking you again. When are you collecting it to show to the people? We can't wait for indefinitely. 2 years, I remember Mr. Parikar 2 years back has given you an opportunity. If you are not interested, you say, rag and kicker, we are not interested. Then we will see how to do it all on our own. This is one part of it. And we will recover the money what we have given you also, because your plan is useless.
Exactly, that's what I
am trying to say. If you want, if you have a plan, if you have to implement the plan, you please explain to us that correction and correct the plan. We will show it to the public. And we will request as a minister, we will defer it. But when are you going? We can't wait indefinitely. We can't wait indefinitely. 2 years are given to you. We are now 2019 and another new plan will perform. I cannot be like somebody who was in 96 and 2011. In the interest of the state, we have to finish the plan. So when are you giving you? Do you commit to the people here? Postponing, no problem. That is up to the decision. When I will write to them. That is one part of it. But first part is when are you giving me the way you have to correct it and give it to the people of Goa?
These guidelines are given to you by the National Coastal Zone Management.
Tom, you are going to ask him questions. You are telling. Why you do this?
Because Vivesh is telling, they have to only confirm the land records and confirm the land.
No, I could get out of
here. You want the help of the government, you want people from the survey department, you want people from the WRA department, you want from the agriculture department. Which department will give you 24 hours? You stay here for 24 hours and get it done. When you are doing that, you tell me.
Department is the boiler.